Okay, sir.
Good morning, students. Today we will have a discussion on the topic fluid mechanics. In this, we are starting with a subtopic pressure and density. And here in the beginning, I am not going to take time for explaining some of these points. But in every question, I'd like to present the concept on which the problem is solved. And wherever it is required, I'll provide you the information. Here we are solving the questions for course material exercises. First, we are starting with concept pressure and density. In this, we will come across terms like pressure, thrust, density, relative density, and all. Generally, pressure is nothing but force exerted by the fluid on any surface in contact with it, and it is equal to force per unit area. Force exerted by the fluid on the surface in contact per unit area is called pressure. And in this pressure, again we will come up, we'll learn like the terms like gauge pressure, absolute pressure, atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure means pressure exerted by the atmosphere. Gauge pressure means pressure due to a liquid column or a gas column. And absolute pressure means sum of the atmospheric pressure and gauge pressure. And as we know, density is ratio of mass to volume of substance. And again, whenever it is required, I'll define the terms required. Now we will start with the first question, which is like, in a hydraulic lift at a service station, the radii of large and small pistons are in the ratio of 20:1. What weight placed on the small piston will be sufficient to lift a car of mass 1200 kg? Options: 3 kg force, 30 kg force, 300 kg force, 3000 kg force. Now this question, as we read, it is understood that it is based on hydraulic lift. It is shown as in the diagram. It is consisting of a vessel which is containing liquid at rest, and it is fitted with two pistons. One is smaller in size, one is larger in size, and generally we apply force on the smaller piston, which will produce a large force which is sufficient to lift automobiles at this larger piston. And this device works on the principle of Pascal's law. That is why we mentioned here the concept hydraulic lift is an application of Pascal's law. And as per the Pascal's law here, whenever there is a change in pressure in enclosed fluid which is in rest condition, the same change in pressure will be produced everywhere. That means if you apply pressure here, the same amount of pressure will be produced here. That's why here, if F1 is a force applied on a smaller piston which is of radius smaller, and F2 is a force that is exerted by the larger piston of radius capital R, then the pressure at both the points should be equal. That means why F1 by pi R square is equal to F2 by pi cap. Here, force is produced on the smaller piston and force is produced by the larger piston. Force is developed at the larger piston. This you need to note. And as per the question, the ratio of radii is given. That is why capital R by small r is equal to 20:1. And the weight of the car to be lifted here will be equal to the force which is required to be produced by the larger piston. That is why F2 is equal to weight of the car to be lifted. Here we are writing in the units of kg force. Mass of the car is given as 1200 kg, so weight will become 1200 kg force. Now, using the formula which we have mentioned already, F1 by pi small r square is equal to F2 by pi capital R square. So we have to find the formula value of F1, that is a force applied on small piston. So we are writing, we are rearranging the terms from this, and we are getting the formula F1 is equal to F2 into small r by capital R whole square. F2 is 1200 kg force and small r by capital R is 1/20. Given value is capital R by small r, but here we require small r by capital R. That is why we are writing it as 1/20 whole square. So now on simplifying, you are going to get 3 kg force as an answer here. On simplifying, 1200 kg force into 1/20 whole square, you are going to get 3 kg force as an answer. That means option is, correct option is option A. Now, Let us move to next question. Second question. A cylindrical vessel containing a liquid is closed by a smooth piston of mass M. If A is a cross-sectional area of the piston and P naught is the atmospheric pressure, then the pressure of the liquid just below the piston is. Options P naught, P naught plus mg by A, mg by A, and data is not sufficient. So here we have to find pressure just below the piston. Here we have given a diagram. This is the cylindrical vessel which is having piston of mass M placed above the liquid. So now above the piston we have atmosphere and below the piston we have the liquid. So now there will be totally three forces acting on the piston here. One force is weight mg, which is acting in downward direction, and two forces are due to the pressures which are present over there, pressure above and below the piston. And when you know pressure, you can calculate the force by using this formula. Force on a surface is equal to pressure on a surface into area on which the pressure is exerted. So here there are two pressures. One is atmospheric pressure, which is the pressure above the piston. That is P naught. We are considering it as P naught. So P naught into A force will be acting from above to downward direction. And if suppose P is the pressure just below this piston due to this liquid present, then the pressure will be acting upwards and it will be equal to P into A. That's why we have mentioned here in this question, forces acting on the piston are weight of the piston mg downwards and force due to air or atmosphere above it, that is P naught A, which is in downward direction, and force due to liquid just below it, which is P into A in upward direction. So totally three forces are acting on the piston. And now we consider the equilibrium position of condition of the piston. If the piston is in equilibrium, the net upward force and net downward force must be equal. That is why we are mentioning here, if the piston is in equilibrium, it means force on piston in downward direction is equal to force on piston in upward direction. In downward direction, we have two forces, which is P naught A plus mg, the total downward force, and the force in upward direction is PA. Actually, you may write it, write the LHS as RHS, RHS as LHS to be more exact. Here I have preferred this because I have to find the pressure P here. So if you, in the equation we have PA, if you want P, divide this entire equation with A, you are going to get P is equal to P naught plus mg by A. That means the correct option is option B. Then the third question. A uniformly tapering vessel of height H, whose lower and upper radii are small r and capital R, is completely filled with a liquid of density rho. The force that acts on the base of the vessel due to the liquid is pi capital R square h rho g, pi small r square h rho g, pi into capital R plus small r whole square h rho g, 1 by 3 into pi into capital R square minus r square h rho g. Uniformly tapering vessel, they have given the question. Tapering vessel means it is as appeared in this diagram. There will be no uniform cross section throughout. Here, from top surface to bottom surface, the pressure is, the area of cross section is decreasing as per the description. And here, according to question, there is a h height of liquid filled in this container, and we have to find force on the base of the vessel. As already I mentioned in the previous question, force on any surface can be found by using the formula pressure on surface into area on which the pressure is exerted. So here, the bottom surface is having circular surface, that is circular cross section. So the area would become pi small r square. And now you have to find the pressure on the surface. Here pressure is due to height h of the liquid. That means pressure due to liquid column of height h. That will be given by the formula rho g h, where rho is the density of the liquid, g is acceleration due to gravity, and h is the height of the liquid column above the base. That we are using here. So the solution would be like this. Force on the base of the vessel due to liquid is nothing but pressure due to liquid column above the base into area of the base. So pressure here is rho gh and area of the base is pi r square. So F is equal to rho gh into pi r square, or on rearranging, we are getting F is equal to pi r square into h rho g. That is option number B. Option B. Then, question number 4. The diameter of the piston of a hydraulic automobile is capital D meter. What pressure in atmosphere is required to lift a car of mass m kg? Here, this in atmosphere we should understand as unit of the pressure here. The pressure they want us to express in the units of atmosphere. It is not atmospheric pressure, that we need to keep in mind. So now, for this, we want pressure that is required to lift a car of mass m. That is nothing but when you are using the hydraulic lift, how much pressure should be applied on the smaller piston, that we should find here. As we know, force on the small piston can be calculated by pressure on the small piston into area on which the pressure is exerted. We are taking this as force exerted by the piston to lift a car is equal to weight of the car, because finally we have to lift a car. That means we need to exert the force on the large piston, or the large piston should be exerting a force which is equal to weight of the car. That is nothing but pressure exerted by the piston into area of the piston. One small correction I want to make in my explanation. Here we need to find the pressure exerted by the larger piston, not the pressure applied on the smaller piston. I also said earlier differently. So here pressure exerted by the larger piston we have to find. So force exerted by the piston is equal to pressure exerted by piston into area of the piston. Here area of the piston, as per the question, piston is having diameter D, so the area of piston would become pi D square by 4 here. Pi R square, R is equal to D by 2 if you use, you are going to get area is pi D square by 4. So pressure, if we assume as capital P, it will become the equation like P into pi D square by 4 is equal to mg, and you have to find value of P, pressure, that will become 4 mg divided by pi D square in SI units of Pascal. But the question says pressure in atmosphere. So we need a relation here between the atmosphere unit and Pascal unit that we have mentioned here in an approximate relation. Actually, one atmosphere is nearly equal to 10 power 5 Pascal. Actually, this is an approximate relation. To make the calculation simple in objective, we use this relation. Originally, one atmosphere is equal to 1.5 Pascal. So here, if you use this relation, you can get 1 Pascal is equal to 1 divided by 10 power 5 atmosphere, that we are substituting in place of Pascal. We are writing 1 divided by 10 power 5 atmosphere, that becomes 4 mg divided by pi d square into 10 power 5 atmosphere. So the option which is correct is option A. Then number 5. A 50 kg girl wearing heel shoes balances on a single heel. The heel is circular with a diameter 1 cm. The pressure exerted by the heel on the horizontal floor, take g is equal to 10 meter per second square. And if you see the options, all the options are in Pascal, 6.4 into 10 power 4 Pascal, 6.4 into 10 power 5 Pascal, 6.4 into 10 power 6 Pascal, 6.4 into 10 power 7 Pascal. So answer is in SI units. So all the values which you should use should be also in SI units. That is why here, firstly, we are writing the mass which is in SI unit already as it is, but diameter we are changing the unit from centimeter to meter, because the answers are in SI units. We are writing all the values in SI units. Now you have to find the pressure exerted by the heel. So pressure on any surface, if you want to find, that would be given by the formula. Pressure on a surface is equal to force on a surface divided by area of the surface on which pressure is exerted. This is important for us. Area of the surface on which pressure is exerted. Sometimes the pressure may not be exerted on the entire area, or the force may not be exerted on the entire area, but a limited area. So whenever you are calculating the pressure, you need to consider only the area on which that pressure is acting, or the force is acting here. That you need to keep in mind. So here, the force which is exerted on the horizontal floor will become weight of the girl, which is nothing but mg. And since the heel is circular, only on through that circular area the pressure will be acting, or the force will be acting. That's why area of the surface on which the pressure is exerted is area of the circular heel, which is nothing but pi d square by 4. K is equal to pi r square, which is equal to pi d square by 4. So as per the formula, pressure exerted is equal to F by A, F is equal to mg, and A is equal to pi d square by 4. On rearranging, we are getting it as 4 mg divided by pi d square. Then on substitution, we are going to get the answer as 6.4 into 10 power 6 Newton per meter square. Newton per meter square can also be expressed as Pascal. Here for your reference, I have given the units. With units, I have substituted the values. Here kg meter per second square is nothing but a Newton. So the unit here obtained as Newton per meter square. Then Newton per meter square is rewritten as Pascal. The correct option would be option C in this case. Then, question number 6. A U-tube contains water and methylated spirit separated by mercury. The mercury columns in the two arms are at the same level with 10 cm of water in one arm and 12.5 cm of spirit in the other, as shown in figure. The relative density of the spirit is. So as per the question, a U-tube is consisting of water and spirit in two limbs with 10 cm of water in one limb and 12.5 cm of spirit in other. Mercury in both the limbs is in same horizontal level as you see here. Then we have to find the relative density of spirit. Relative density is nothing but density of substance divided by density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. We have to finally find this relative density, that is density of spirit divided by density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. And now here we are using the concept of Pascal's law, which is stating like in a liquid at rest, the pressure is same at two points in the same horizontal level. See, if you see the diagram, point A and point B, that is the mercury levels in either limbs are at same horizontal level. Point A and point B are at same horizontal level. That is why we are mentioning that point A and point B are at same horizontal level. So as per the Pascal's law, first concept here, which we have mentioned, pressure at A must be equal to pressure at B. At A, the two pressures are acting actually. One is due to the atmosphere here above this water level, and then due to this water column. That is why pressure at A is equal to atmospheric pressure plus pressure due to water column. And this will be P naught, that is atmospheric pressure. And already in the previous question, we learnt about pressure due to liquid column, rho GH. So in that way, we are having rho W G into HW. Rho W means density of water, G is acceleration due to gravity, HW is height of water column. And then at point B, we have two pressures, two. One is due to atmosphere and one is due to spirit column. So the pressure at point B is equal to, pressure at point B is equal to atmospheric pressure plus pressure due to spirit column. So here atmospheric pressure is P naught and pressure due to spirit column is rho S G into HS. Rho S is density of spirit, HS is height of the spirit column. On either side, P naught is there, so we cancel it and we get the relation here, rho W G HW is equal to rho S GHS. Actually, you can use this as shortcut for such kind of questions. Directly, you can start with this. Rho WGHW is equal to rho S GHW. Sorry, rho S GHS. Either sides G is cancelled. And you want relative density. As we already mentioned, it is equal to density of substance divided by density of water. So relative density of spirit is given by density of spirit divided by density of water. That is nothing but height of the water column divided by height of the spirit column. On substituting 10 cm as height of water column, 12.5 cm as height of spirit column, we are ending with the relative density as 0.8. That is correct option is option B. Now, connecting to previous question, we have the next question. In previous question, if 15 cm of water and spirit each are further poured into the respective arms of the tube, difference in the level of mercury in the two arms is, take relative density of mercury equal to 13.6. So here, this is the situation. Initially, we had the situation of this kind, 10 cm of water in one arm and in another arm, 12.5 cm of spirit. But now, 15 cm of water is added here further. So the water column is 25 cm in height, and 15 centimeter of spirit is added in the second column, so it will become 27.5 centimeter of spirit column. Now, earlier these two liquids are having same pressure at point A and point B, but now since the new addition of liquid size is done, the pressure may be slightly different. That we need to check here. If pressures are same again, then A and B will be lying in having mercury top surface of mercury. But if pressures are different, then mercury at point A or point B depressed, and at other point it will be rising. So here we are checking that pressure due to water column is equal to rho W G into HW. That is nothing but rho W into G into 25 centimeter. I did not substitute the water's density here because everything here can be expressed in the density of water. So I have left that substitution part. Only I substituted height of the water column. And then pressure due to spirit column is equal to rho S G into HS. And from previous question we got this relation. Rho S is equal to 0.8 rho W from last step of previous question. So rho S is 0.8 rho W into G into, now the height of the spirit column is 27.5 centimeter. So it will end as pressure due to spirit column as rho W into G into 22 centimeter. This is rho W G 22 centimeter, and water column is exerting a pressure of rho W G 25 centimeter. Clearly pressure due to water column is more. That means in this arm the mercury will go down, and in this arm mercury will be slightly rising up. That's why here, if you see the points A and B, again we are marking them newly. At point A and B, which are at same horizontal level, if you consider, at point B, along with spirit column, we have height H of mercury here, and A and B are at same horizontal level, so we will get same pressure. Or else we can say that pressure at A and pressure at B, or pressure due to this water column and pressure due to spirit column, if you take the difference of it, it will give us the pressure due to this mercury column. Because we can write a relation here, actually we did not mention in this slide, but you can note down, pressure at A, that is pressure due to water column of 25 centimeter, is equal to pressure due to 27.5 centimeter of spirit column plus pressure due to the mercury column. So if you want pressure due to mercury column, you can subtract the pressure due to water and pressure due to spirit that we have mentioned here. Pw minus Ps is equal to rho m gh. Rho m here I have considered as density of mercury, and they have given relative density of mercury as 13.6. So we are going to get density of mercury as 13.6 times density of water. So I have substituted these things here. Rho w g into 25 centimeter minus rho w g into 22 centimeter is equal to 13.6 into rho w g h, which is like 25 centimeter, because rho w g is same all over the terms. We cancelled it, and we are just having 25 centimeter minus 22 centimeter is equal to 13.6 h. That is 3 centimeter is equal to 13.6 h. We want h, that is the difference in the mercury levels, as that is 3 divided by 13.6 centimeter, which is 0.22 centimeter. The correct option is option B. Once again, I want to mention here, if you want to find this height of the mercury column, which is different in the two limbs, it will be given by the pressure due to this mercury column is equal to pressure due to water column minus pressure due to spirit column. Next question. Three vessels A, B, and C of different shapes contain water up to same height as shown in figure. PA, PB, and PC be the pressures exerted by the water at the bottom of the vessels A, B, and C respectively. Then, if you see the diagram, the three vessels are of different shapes and are of different base area. But one thing common is, as per the question, the liquid in all these containers is same, that is water. And one more thing is, the water is filled to same height in all of them. Now, here if you want to find pressure at the bottom of the vessel, that would be nothing but pressure due to water column, that is pressure is equal to rho gh. Now we are mentioning the formula for PA, PB and PC, like PA is equal to rho A GHA, PB is equal to rho B GHB, PC is equal to rho C GHC. Here rho A, rho B, rho C are densities of liquids in those containers, but according to question, the three vessels are containing water. So all these densities will be equal. All these densities will be equal. That is why rho A is equal to rho B is equal to rho C. And here HA, HB, HC are the heights of the liquid column in those containers. But according to question, the water is filled up to the same height. So these heights are also equal. HA is equal to HB is equal to HC. So densities are equal in all the containers. Heights of liquid are also equal in all the containers. And already G is same everywhere. So in those three containers. So the correct relation between PA, PB, PC is that they are equal. PA is equal to PB is equal to PC. So the correct option is option D. Then question number 9. A U-tube in which the cross-sectional area of the limb on the left is 1/4 the limb on the right contains mercury with density 13.6 gram per centimeter cube. The level of mercury in the narrow limb is at a distance of 36 centimeter from the upper end of the tube. What will be the rise in the level of mercury in the right limb if the left limb is filled to the top of the water? So initially there is no water here. In that condition, the mercury in left limb and mercury in right limb are in same level. But when we fill the water here, left limb is consisting of water above the mercury and right limb is consisting of only air above it. So due to the pressure of water here, mercury in the right limb will rise, and how much rise it is, we have to find. And here density is given in the units of gram per centimeter cube. Density is 13.6 gram per centimeter cube. And here in this question, again I am using the concept of the Pascal's law, which states in liquid at rest, the pressure is same at two points in the same horizontal level. Now before going to exactly what we need to do some work for bringing the relation we require between the levels of the changes in levels of liquid in either limbs. So here we are going with the information given that cross-sectional area of the limb on the left is 1/4, that means 1/4 times the limb on the right. That means area of the left limb is equal to 1/4 of area of the right limb. Actually, to be more exact, it is area of cross section. Area of cross section of the left limb is equal to 1/4 into area of cross section of right limb. And now, when the left limb is filled with water, I am assuming X and Y represent the rise in level of mercury in the right limb and fall in level of mercury in the left limb. So X is the rise in level of mercury in the right limb and Y is the fall in level of mercury in the left limb. So now you need to keep in mind, since the areas of the two limbs or area of cross section of the two limbs are not same, the level of mercury falling in this limb and the level of mercury rising in this limb will not be the same. That is why firstly we have to find the relation between this X and Y. In this case, you need to keep in mind, though the levels X and Y are different, the volume of mercury which is falling in left limb will be equal to volume of mercury rising in the right limb. That's why here we are taking the formula for volume of the liquid, that is area of cross section of the limb into the level of mercury that is changing. So AL into Y is equal to AR into X. But we are writing the relation here, AL is equal to 1/4 AR. So we are getting 1/4 ary is equal to ar into x. Thus, that gives us the relation y is equal to 4x. That means here initially the water is up to 36 centimeter, means water is filled through 36 centimeter. But initially the mercury level is 36 centimeter from the top, but due to the filled water, it is going to be 36 plus 4x centimeter below the top surface. That means it is indicated in the diagram. See that initially this position, this is 36 centimeter. This is actually without water, but when water is filled along with this 36 centimeter, it is going to push this mercury slightly downward. That is through 4x distance. That is why this is 36 centimeter and this is 4x centimeter. So totally above this mercury in left limb, we have 36 plus 4x centimeter of water column. And now here at the same horizontal level in the right limb, we have a point called B dash here. Above this B dash, we have totally 4x plus x, totally 5x centimeter of mercury above this point. So here A dash and B dash are at same horizontal level. So total pressure at A dash is equal to total pressure at B dash. That means atmospheric pressure plus water pressure at point A dash is equal to atmospheric pressure plus mercury pressure at point B dash. That's why we are writing it here. Pressure at A dash is equal to pressure at B dash as they are at same horizontal level. That is atmospheric pressure plus rho W into G into 36 plus 4x centimeter. That is pressure due to water is equal to P naught plus rho M into G into x plus 4x centimeter. That is pressure due to mercury. Here density of mercury as per the question is given as 13.6 gram per centimeter cube. And here I have used the relation that density of water in CGS system as 1 gram per centimeter cube. So I have written density of mercury is equal to 13.6 rho W. If you want, you can simply substitute the values. Rho W is equal to 1 gram per centimeter cube and rho M is equal to 13.6 gram per centimeter cube. It is also okay. And here on either side, P naught is cancelled. So now here we got rho W and G in on either sides. So it will be cancelled and it will be coming to this 36 plus 4x centimeter is equal to 68x centimeter. So 36 centimeter is equal to 64x centimeter, which is nothing but x is equal to 0.56 centimeter. That means the level of mercury that is rising, the level of mercury that is rising compared to the original. Initially the mercury was at B. So above point B, it is rising by 0.56 centimeter. So the correct option is option C. I'd like to repeat this once again quickly. Since the two limbs are not having same area of cross section, when water is introduced, the level of liquid falling in left limb is not equal to level of liquid rising in right limb. That is why first we are finding the relation between them using the concept that volume of the liquid rising in one limb is equal to volume of the liquid falling in the one limb. So we got relation y is equal to 4x. So the level of water in the left limb finally becomes 36 plus 4x centimeter. And at this mercury level, which is mentioned as A dash, we are taking the same horizontal level point B dash in the other limb. Now above that we have totally 4x plus x centimeter of mercury. So we got into this solution. Next, question number 10. Question number 10. Two communicating vessels contain mercury. The diameter of one vessel is n times larger than the diameter of the other. A column of water of height h is poured into the left vessel. The mercury level will rise in the right hand vessel. Here S is relative density of mercury and rho is density of water. The mercury level will rise in the right hand vessel by. That means just like in the previous question, we have to find the rise in level of mercury in this limb. But here the relation between diameters are given here instead of relation between areas. But still the approach would be almost the same. See here, the diameter of right vessel is equal to n times that of left vessel. So here the quantities related to right part are indicated by number 1 here, and the ones related to the left vessel are indicated by 2 here. So d2, diameter of the second vessel, that is right vessel, is equal to n times the diameter of the left vessel. D2 is equal to n d1. So now here, if h1 and h2 are changes in levels of mercury in the two vessels, when vessel is filled with water, when the left vessel is filled with water, we are having h1 and h2 representing fall in level of mercury in left vessel and rise in level of mercury in right vessel respectively. Already we learned from previous question that volume of mercury rising in one vessel is equal to volume of mercury falling in one vessel. So we are writing A2 H2 is equal to A1 H1. Then areas we are expressing in terms of diameter. So pi D2 square by 4 H2 is equal to pi D1 square by 4 into H1. Pi by 4 will be cancelled in either sides. And here D2 is written as ND1 from the relation given from the question. So ND1 whole square into H2 is equal to D1 square H1. So here N square D1 square we will get. D1 square and D1 square will be cancelled. So the remaining is N square H2 is equal to H1. So this is the relation between the changes in levels of mercury in either lens. Now, so here the water is to height H in the left limb. And if you assume that on introduction of water, the mercury level is falling through a height of H1 in the left limb, then the H2 is a rise in the level of mercury in the left limb. If you consider the points in the same horizontal level here as a point A, which is mercury level in a left limb. If you consider the point B on the right limb at the same horizontal level, it will consist of totally H1 plus H2 level of mercury above it. That means here pressure due to atmosphere and water column of height H in the left limb is equal to pressure due to atmosphere and mercury column of height H1 plus H2. So pressure at A is equal to pressure at B as they are in same horizontal level. That gives atmospheric pressure plus pressure due to water column, rho WGH is equal to atmospheric pressure plus mercury column pressure. So rho M into G into H1 plus H2. Now atmospheric pressure is cancelled and G on either sides also is cancelled. Then we are getting this relation H is equal to rho M by rho W into N square H2 plus H1, H2. Here we have used the relation H1 is equal to N square H2 just derived. And now rho M by rho W, that is nothing but ratio of mercury density to water's density, which is nothing but specific gravity of mercury. As per the question, it is S. So H becomes S into N square plus 1 into H2, where we have taken H2 common from these complete two terms. Now we have to find the value of H2, which is rise of the level of mercury in this second container, that we are writing as H2 is equal to H divided by S into N square plus 1. So the correct option is option B. Next question is question number 11. A L-shaped glass tube is kept that is moving with constant acceleration. During the motion, the level of liquid in the left arm is at 12 cm, whereas in the right arm it is at 8 cm. When the orientation of the tube is as shown, assuming that the diameter of the tube is much smaller than levels of the liquid and neglecting the effect of surface tension, the acceleration of bus will be. Sir. Sir, shall we stop, sir?
Hello, sir.
Yes. Shall I end, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Stop.
Okay. Okay.
Sir,
meeting time is 9:00.
Upload.